With Scratch Face Sensing Blocks, you can create interactive projects that use the features of your face. This AI-powered extension uses a machine learning model to detect if it sees a face and where a nose, eyes, ears, mouth, etc. are. The blocks do not collect or store personal information, like recordings or images of your face, making it a safe, fun, and creative way to explore the possibilities of AI. To get started, add the face sensing extension blocks by clicking on the extension menu.
Hello.
Let's try it out. I've got Eric, the director of Scratch Lab, here to help us experiment.
You may need to allow camera permissions to get your video to appear on the stage, but then you can use this go to nose block. If you click on it, the cat will jump to your nose. Here, I'll click again. And again, if I want the cat to stick to my face, I can use a forever block. And now when I click on that, the cat follows me around. I can also stick it to my ear or even make it spin while it's there.
Let's try another experiment and make a hat or another object stick to our head, like a face filter. You can choose a sprite that is a fashion item, like a hat or glasses, from the sprites available in the sprite library. Or in the costume paint editor, try drawing a funny hat using the brush or shape tools. Using what you learned in our first experiment, can you write a script to make the sprite stick to the top of your head? Here I've altered a script that Eric showed us to make this hat continually go to the top of my head.
Notice that this hat doesn't quite fit on my head the way that I expected. It's really low on my face. I can actually change the position of this hat by going back to my costume, selecting the entire costume, and then moving it around until it's just in the right place on the top of my head. I also noticed this hat may be too big or too small for my head. I could resize it using the tools, or I could actually use a bit of code. How does your costume respond if you're close to the camera versus further away? When you tilt your head, does it follow the tilt, or does it just sort of sit awkwardly atop your forehead? We can actually use some code blocks to change this. Do you see some blocks that we could use? For instance, I can add this set size to face size block. When I get close to the camera or further away, the hat changes size based on the size of my face in the webcam. I can also add this block point in direction of face tilt. Now when I turn my head, my hat goes with me, just like a normal hat would.
At Scratch, we're focused on making tools to help learners express their own creative ideas. That's why we're experimenting with AI, to let you explore new possibilities like face sensing. It is important to note that our face sensing blocks try to detect if a face exists, but they're not able to identify who the face is, or even if it is a human face. That means the AI we use for face sensing sometimes makes interesting mistakes. Identifying these mistakes can help us see the difference between our own human intelligence and AI. So for example, the AI can detect the face of a toy like this, if I hold it up close to the camera. But what about this whale? It definitely has a face, but it's not that human-like. So you can see the AI makes the costume jump around a lot. Now, what about a drawing of a face? It'll detect even a very simple drawing like this smiley face, especially if we get it close up. One thing I've learned is that the drawing actually can be just a circle that's filled in. But what I have to do is fill the screen with the white paper. And then it actually thinks that's a face. That's a way the AI sees a little differently from a person. What if my face is partly covered up? Well, if it's covered all the way, it can't see me, but even if it can just see the top of my head and my eyes, it works really well. That's kind of surprising. The AI we're using for face sensing was created by training it on millions of photos of people's faces. It detects faces based on the patterns it has seen in those photos, like the arrangement of the eyes, nose, and mouth relative to each other. That's also why it sometimes makes mistakes.
Thanks, Eric. I can't wait to experiment with objects around my house to see what the AI recognizes as a face, and then create games and other interactive projects with these blocks.